again?
I think there are a lot of people out there, and I don't want to be flip about this, I think there are a lot of people out there who are happy that this at least didn't happen while President Trump was watching Fox and Friends, and instead it happened when he was out on the golf course and he was informed about this by layers of advisors and such, because we know that historically misunderstandings and false alarms have almost led to nuclear confrontation, nuclear war. Are you at all about the fact that an accident, a misunderstanding might lead to something like
this?
There's
no question, and that really highlights the global consequence of what Hawaii just went through yesterday. This is not just about what happened to Hawaii. And this is where I really hope that people across the country, that leaders here in Washington are paying attention to what people went through and what the consequences of that can be. So we are facing a very direct nuclear threat from North Korea. By the way, we also are the country with Russia, where we have thousands of nuclear weapons pointed at each other that could be launched within a moment's notice. So understanding what is at stake here, when we're talking about nuclear war and the threat of nuclear war hanging over our heads, it's not just the president making a decision to launch a nuclear weapon. It's these kinds of mistakes that we have seen happen in the past that bring us to this brink of nuclear war that could be unintentional. And that's really what is at stake here for the people of Hawaii. And what makes me angry is, yes, that this false alarm went out and we have to fix that in Hawaii, but really we've got to get to the underlying issue here of why are the people of Hawaii in this country facing a nuclear threat coming from North Korea today? And what is this president doing urgently to eliminate that threat?
Now, you said that he's taking too long to deal with this, and he's not taking the threat from North Korea seriously. What do you want President Trump to be doing?
Well, I've been talking about the seriousness of this threat for years, since I came here to Congress, and I've been calling on President Trump to directly negotiate with North Korea, to sit across the table from Kim Jong-un, work out the differences so that we can build a pathway towards denuclearization to remove this threat. There's a few things that have to happen in order for those negotiations to be successful. First of all, they have to happen without preconditions. And this has been a learned lesson from the decades of failed leadership that the people of Hawaii are paying the price for now, where they set these unrealistic preconditions. For example, saying, North Korea, we're only going to talk to you if you first get rid of your nuclear weapons. What would be the point of having a conversation if they get rid of their nuclear weapons? There'd be nothing to talk about at that point. But the second issue is understanding why North Korea has developed and is holding on so tightly to these nuclear weapons, because they see it as the only deterrent against the U.S. coming in and overthrowing the regime there. So that exists as a result, again, of our decades-long regime change war policies around the world, that North Korea is now in a position where Kim Jong-un is saying, no way, I'm not going to give up these nuclear weapons, because he doesn't see that credible message coming from the United States that we're not interested in overthrowing your government. We're interested in removing this nuclear threat from our country and the world.
Congresswoman Gabbard, we always like having you on the show, and I'm really sorry it was under these conditions. Please convey to the people of Hawaii how much the rest of us care about what happened.